Hei, da jeg på Eggemoen flyplass på Hønefoss på Mercedes-event for å teste den nye elbilen til Mercedes, Mercedes EQC. Denne bilen stappet med alt mulig tech, og visst nok også ganske selvkjørende, så det blir spennende å se. Så bli med ut, så tar vi en tur.
Det første som skjer at vi skal ut og se hvor fort bilen går fra 0 til 100, og det en annen journalist som begynner med å kjøre.
Brakes. Oh, Jesus Christ.
Heldigvis så var det ikke noe å krasje I. Og så det min tur, og 0,100 på 5,1 sekund. Det ganske raskt.
All the way up to 100 kilometers per hour.
And as fast as I can.
As fast as you can, exactly. So it's 0 to 100. A drag start pretty much in this amazing car.
Okay. Ready, set,
go. Go. To 100.
Yeah.
Jeg styrer gjennom noen kjegler og får kjent litt på bilen, og den utrolig behagelig å kjøre.
But it also goes with higher velocities.
Kid saved.
Kid saved. And as you can see, it's super close, right?
It's super close.
And it was hidden, you know? Yeah. I think that's the most advantage of the system.
Yeah.
It recognizes persons who are just jumping into the street, especially when they are hidden as well, because that's normal in cities, right? Mm. If there is anything happen with the driver, he's not paying attention, you still have the active brake assist who supports to save. And as soon as it finds a parking, yeah, I can select it. I can select forward or reverse.
Bilen parkerer faktisk også seg selv helt alene.
I have to change the gear and then it's gonna do the blinking for me and the parking.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah, I choose the like really small parking spot.
Yeah.
So, but still it can do it. It takes a bit more. And as soon as it's standing in there, it will tell me.
Perfect.
Finish.
All right.
Utrolig deilig å kjøre, rett og slett. Så vi har 408 hestekrefter, 760 newtonmeter drivemoment, og en rekkevidde på 417 kilometer. Bilen veier 2,5 tonn. Så det en ganske tung bil, så den ligger veldig godt på veien. Hvis jeg litt på vei ut av grøfta, så kjenner jeg at den vibrerer rolig I rattet og sier fra at nå jeg på vei ut av banen.
Bilens cruisekontroll kjører seg selv, og det ganske utrolig imponerende. Men det går ikke så veldig mange sekunder før bilen ber deg legge hendene på rattet igjen.
Mercedes har også sin egen stemmeassistent som man kan prate til. Den heter Hi Mercedes.
What do you want to do?
I'm cold.
So, what were you thinking about when you designed this car?
You always think about something beautiful, because this is at the end what makes every Mercedes. It always has to be a beauty.
Is there any challenges that you face when you design electric vehicles compared to ordinary vehicles?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, we were designing combustion engine cars for decades, and definitely you have to think a little bit in a different way, because you have to deal with different proportions, you have to deal with a battery suddenly that is somewhere, and with this particular car, I mean, generally it's much easier to design an SUV or crossover car with a battery underneath than a lower car. Yeah, this will be more of a challenge. So that car was quite fun, but still there were certain elements that they were not exactly walk in the park. For example, how we managed to, let's say that you don't see that there is a heavy and big battery underneath. We did it quite a lot of work on the seal, on the rocker area. Together with our engineers, we were fighting for months, yeah? Because they wanted a huge, let's say, side impact protection, and we didn't want that the car look heavy. And at the end, we came up with a very clever solution. We have a running board. They are really good also in terms of aerodynamic.
Yeah.
Yeah? Yeah. So the car is amazingly good.
Who would you consider to be your biggest competitor?
I mean, so far there are not that many competitors, yeah, if we are honest.
Did you like take any ideas from Tesla or when it comes to battery?
No, because first of all, there are so many, let's say, brand core values that really are important for Mercedes that just would not match to that what they are doing, but they have completely different strategy and different design philosophy. Yeah. You know, ours is just is called try to do everything as sensual as possible, and in contrast with purity, so sensual and pure. Yeah. This is what we are designing to every car, not only EQs. Mm. And EQs is kind of with EQC we started, let's say, to write a new story, and there will be approximately 10 cars within next, let's say, 2.5 years, 3 years, and they will be smaller, higher, or higher positioned and bigger than EQC, and that will be very, very interesting.
Is there any reason why you should continue designing cars that are not electric anymore?
That are not electric? Yeah. I mean, you're from Norway, so maybe the reason you have different answer, but we still consider, let's say, the business that we have as a core business. We do combustion engine cars. Still, we won't stop them overnight. So they will still be there for years, but they will be much more clean and efficient, and there will be a parallel, let's say, family of cars. We call it EQ, electric intelligence. We will just give another choice to customer.
Yeah.
And I guess in Norway, it's pretty obvious what the customer will go for.
It is.
All right.
Okay, yeah, thank you. Thank you very much.
All right.
Yeah,
very thank nice. You.
Okay, det var Mercedes EQC. Jeg er Trole for ITavisen på Ensyn.